China's peaceful rise is a truly historic, with positive repercussions throughout the world. The country has achieved tangible results in changing the livelihood of its people and working towards the UN 17 Sustainable Development Goals, especially in terms of poverty alleviation and green development. The UAE shares China's vision to build an inclusive, innovative, and vibrant future.
I think China has many experiences to show to the world, specifically in development, in poverty eradication, in agriculture, in technology, and many other areas.
We have the Chinese that they're into. We have agriculture, for instance, you know about the Wanbao project that is in Shaishai. It's one of the biggest projects in the rice production. The production, they have increased the product, like in 1 hectare, it used to be like 2 tons by harvest. But now with this investment from China, it has they have reached 8 tons in the same. They are working with the local farmers to transfer them the technologies for them to increase and to produce better in their own farms. Yes, it's kind of teaching.
So infrastructure projects, developments on the physical space, very impressive. But equally so, I think, is the use of technology to improve the quality of life, the delivery of services. I think it's important for Singapore to understand where China is heading, what are your priorities, so that at each point in time, we can then think about things that we can do together.
China's economy is growing, even with the pandemic, it is growing. It is also expanding its middle class with a phenomenal surplus spending power. It's growing at the same time. So the potential for Sri Lanka as a small developing country is there, and we need to work on exploiting it.
China, of course, is the largest trading partner for Thailand, and it's a major source of investment in Thailand also. Thailand and China still has many areas that we can cooperate more. I think e-commerce will play a very important part in promoting trade and commerce throughout the world, especially between Thailand and China, because both China and Thailand, the people like to go online. They like to follow media influencers, you know, to look at some famous actors or individual people who like to promote products. You know,
China has been responsible for 1/3 of the world's growth in the last decade and will continue. Then you have the Belt and Road Initiative. You have the train departed from Yiwu in Zhejiang province, crisscrossing Eurasia, and part comes to Spain. The level of interaction is incredible.
The most important thing is the way in which you develop your strategy, your policies, because you are not thinking on how much money I will get for them. And this is very important. You are thinking on how we could develop, this is a policy win-win, how could develop together.